Well, on the heels of a repeal of the voter ID law here in New Hampshire, there are now growing calls to review exactly who's eligible to cast a ballot in the Granite State. Exceptions are in place now for non-residents who are students. But when it comes to the domicile requirement, some wonder if the system might be being abused. Good night. Election day is always a big day in New Hampshire. And in the couple of months leading up to the general election last year, Alana Biden, niece of the vice president, worked on the Obama campaign in the Granite State. She voted on election day, swearing in an affidavit her domicile is 145 Steinmetz Drive in Manchester. After the election, she left the state and moved to New York, according to her LinkedIn profile. Currently, State Senator Martha Fuller Clark has 8 people registered to vote under her single family address in Portsmouth, several of whom came to New Hampshire to work on campaigns for various periods of time and voted in elections before moving on. But when asked about the legitimacy of their domicile status, Clark responded by saying, quote, "By and large, the young people who stayed with me were committed to New Hampshire, but given their age, whether they intended to stay is impossible to predict." In fact, according to the Secretary of State's office, the law allows a pretty wide interpretation of who is eligible to vote.
Under the current law, I could move in the day before an election, establish domicile, vote, and then leave the next day.
You could, yes.
But when it comes to voter eligibility, the law reads like this. An inhabitant's domicile for voting purposes is that one place where a person, more than any other place, has established a physical presence and manifests an intent to maintain a single continuous presence.
Because the law is vague in certain areas, it does create areas for problems. And in large part, you have to rely on the trustworthiness of individuals to do the right thing when they're voting. We know that that doesn't always happen.
If cases like this are the practice, then that constitutes drive-through voting.
Manchester attorney Gordon McDonald has worked on several election law cases, and he believes the current system is open for manipulation and ripe for reform.
I think you could take one or two cases and set a very clear message that in New Hampshire, you ought to be domiciled here within the meaning and spirit of our law before you show up and vote.
In 2012, nearly 100,000 voters registered on Election Day, up roughly 25% from 2008. Charged with the task of ensuring who's eligible and detecting fraud, Assistant Attorney General Steve Labonte, who calls the job a challenge.
The way the law is written, a person's intent plays a big role in it. And as with any statute, proving a person's intent can be very difficult.
In fairness, campaign workers from all parties flood the state in election years. But in the home of the first of the nation primary, and given our place on the national stage, McDonald is among those who believe the integrity of our process needs ferocious defense.
Just because it may be hard to enforce a law doesn't mean a law shouldn't be enforced.
All right, well, short of making changes to the state's current law, answers may come through the courts. A trial resulting from a lawsuit brought forth by the League of Women Voters and the ACLU is set for February of next year. The suit is challenging changes made last year to the voter registration law by the Republican majority in Congress.